and Johansson maybe creating a little more room.
Oh, there's no question, and you see Jared understands that too.
Oh boy, Foligno turned around almost. I'd like to see it again. I don't know if it was a slew foot, but he got tangled up with Jeff Carter, and he went down in a heap.
There might have been, there was an official down there.
There he gets tied up with Carter.
Oh. So it's almost like a turnbuckle there. You see how he...
Oh, man.
He didn't see the linesman was sitting...
Centered by 2-2. Bortolo ends up with the puck after a tip and came out through center ice. Down the ice, the puck goes. Cronwall after it, and he is crunched. Oh, what a hit by McLeod. And then McLeod is thrown down to the ice. Well, I'll tell you what. You talk about getting a little of your own medicine. Cronwall has made a living in this league with big hits, and he just got crunched there by Cody McLeod.
Well, Michael, we saw a hit the other night in St. Louis. Lapierre versus Boyle. And he was a five-minute major, and he was kicked out of the game. And when you watch Cromwell, from what I was thinking, he was leaning down. He was bent down when the hit came. And there is that dasher with Boyle hit. And, Mike, I don't want to speculate until we see it, but...
Well, this took, Peter, just 2 minutes and 13 seconds for something to happen in this long-time rivalry. And Cody McLeod is not going to be able to play in the rest of this game. He is going to get kicked out of this one.
McLeod's coming in. And, you know, it's does he see the numbers? Are the numbers right there? They are, Mike. The numbers are right there. And that's the tough one. McLeod is coming so fast, so hard. Look at the numbers, Mike. And
for Jonathan Blum to Yossi in a one-timer. Oh, oh, that got Eves up high in the head.
Oh, jeez.
The rookie let a one-timer go, and there's no way Patrick could get out of the way.
Game. Here it is.
Well, it turned up on the blade. Oof. And up
right
it goes.
Right here. Yeah, it was a knuckleball. Started rolling as he let it go, and that's why it went up so quickly, and Eves wasn't able to react. And you're right, Larry, even with the helmet, you can get
onto the stretcher, badly cut on the side of his right ear.
Here's Oposo trying to keep it in. That's knocked down and brought on by Scheifele. The Schrader. That's Patrick Laine, who McCabe hit. The two 29s colliding right at center ice.
And Jake McCabe, he's cut bad on his face, and he's going to go to the room. But the hit that he laid on Laine right there in the middle of the ice was a devastating hit right there, and he put him down. And Laine, Patrick Laine, he had no idea. He was in serious trouble, and he still is.
It's almost like they're two heads hit.
I'll tell you, Laine could not get up off the ice after the hits, and now he's slowly coming around. But you're going to see him right there. He plays the puck, and as he does, Jake McCabe just stands him straight up. And then everybody converges in off that, but Patrick Laine still down on the ice, slowly getting up now. There's a
boy,
terrific young player right there.
Clash two nights ago. The Caps were victorious. We're off and running this evening with TJ Luxmore and Jean Hébert, the referees, Tim Nowak and Mike Civic. They have the line.
Already a big hit right there. That was Ristolainen on Ovechkin. Caught sort of OV off guard right at the center stripe. He is one big rig, and we expected a lot of hits. They had 41 hits combined in the first game on Monday, and there is a good counterattack. Not sure OV realized how big and strong this kid is.